Let's go to our chief White House correspondent, Jim Acosta. Jim, this is a significant win for the president.
It certainly is. Well, President Trump is declaring victory after his travel ban was upheld by the Supreme Court, but the high court's decision also appears to accuse the president's past insensitive comments about Muslims, the same kind of rhetoric he's using about migrants coming across the border.
All set to.
For President Trump, it was supreme vindication.
A tremendous success, a tremendous victory for the American people and for our Constitution. This is a great victory for our Constitution.
In a 5-4 decision, the Supreme Court upheld the president's travel ban on mostly Muslim-majority countries. Writing for a conservative majority, Chief Justice John Roberts said the ban is squarely within the scope of presidential authority. But in a blistering dissent, Justice Sonia Sotomayor wrote, the majority here completely sets aside the president's charged statements about Muslims as irrelevant. That holding erodes the foundational principles of religious tolerance that the court elsewhere has so emphatically protected. And it tells members of minority religions in our country that they are outsiders, not full members of the political community. That was in reference to Mr. Trump's original call for a ban on all Muslims entering the U.S. from the campaign.
Donald J. Trump is calling for a total and complete shutdown of Muslims entering the United States until our country's representatives can figure out what the hell is going on.
Taking a victory lap, Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell, who blocked Barack Obama's pick of Merrick Garland for the high court, tweeted out a photo of Mr. Trump's Justice Neil Gorsuch. The president's one-word reaction in a tweet, wow.
The ruling shows that all of the attacks from the media and the Democrat politicians are wrong, and they turned out to be very wrong. I want to thank Majority Leader Mitch McConnell for his years of work to make this day very special.
The president used the occasion to tout his hardline stance on migrants coming across the border. An influx, the president said, has prompted calls for thousands of new immigration judges. But that's false. There are no serious calls in Washington for thousands of judges.
They want us to choose 5,000 judges. Can you imagine the corruption? Go to the barbershop, grab somebody, make them a judge. Everybody's being made a judge.
At a rally in South Carolina, the president defended his administration's practice of jailing children who crossed the border with their parents.
And what I learned is one thing. Our facilities are cleaner, better kept, and better run. That's the one thing I learned, okay? I saw that. But what we have is two extremes, and I liked it.
On the same day the White House was calling for civility, the president attacked late-night talk show hosts.
Jimmy Fallon calls me up. And he's like a nice guy. He's lost. He looks like a lost soul.
And he mocked speculation about the First Lady's more private schedule in recent weeks.
They said she got a facelift. No, I would let you know. They couldn't hide that one for long, right?
While railing against the press, the White House is turning to conservative media outlets like Sinclair Broadcasting for sympathetic coverage.
What's something that people at home may not know about you that they're not seeing when you're sparring with the media or representing the president?
Maybe that I'm a little nicer than sometimes the media wants
nice.
To make me out to be. I'm a pretty, I think, happy person. I love life, and I'm a lot nicer, I think, than they make me out to be in the press.
Now, CNN has learned the First Lady is planning on visiting another immigration facility later this week. You'll recall, Wolf, she did that last week down on the border. No confirmation this time of where exactly that will take place. And on another front, we should point out the president is also voicing frustrations today with Harley-Davidson's decision to move some of its production capabilities overseas as Europe is retaliating against the Trump administration over its tariffs on European products coming into the U.S. President tweeted a warning to Harley-Davidson saying if they move overseas, watch, it will be the end of that company. After so many bikers supported the president during the campaign, Wolf, I remember seeing them at those rallies. It is surprising to hear him tell part of his base it's his way or the highway, Wolf.
All right, Jim Acosta, lots going on. Thank you very much.